Aloha everybody, this is Christopher with AG Productions, and welcome to another edition of Watch Me Work. Today we're going to be going back towards our lions of our High Elf Chariot, and what I'm going to focus on today is trying to finish up, or at least get pretty darn close to finishing the face of our model here. So let's go ahead and mix up a little bit of paint, and see what we can do in this short time that we have together. Let's see here, I think I'll go here right now. If that works, let's do 2, 2, and 1 of something else, perhaps. Is that going to work? Maybe? We'll see. Who knows? Alright, there's that, and then one more of those. Okay, so that's going to give us our base color. What I'm doing is trying to come up with a highlight color. I know, roughly speaking, what our base color is. And so what I'm going to do is attempt to lighten that slightly. First of all, mix it up. Mix up the base. Alright, and you can see I'm going actually on top of one of these colors that I've already done. This was the color that I utilized for the hair of the lions. And since we're done with that area of the miniature, I don't really need that area of my palette anymore, and because I use very, very thin paint, this is actually basically completely flat. There's virtually no topography here at all, which is quite nice. It allows me to reuse my palette many, many times over without the issue of getting chunks of paint from the previous layer mixed in with the current layer. So, let's see, that's basically our base color, and while that's sitting there, while I'm deciding what to use, I'm going to paint just a little bit more of this onto some areas that don't quite look painted, just in case. And then this hand over here had some white spots on it. Okay, so I think that's basically about it. Well, there's a little area on the tummy there. Okay, I think we're going to call that pretty good. So I'm going to set that brush to the side. I'm going to, let's see, can the lion sit like that? Yes, he can. Okay, good. Alright, so we're going to take this brush and we're going to set it next to our lamp there. And I'm going to get a smaller brush. Alright, what do I want to use? I have a single zero? I do. Good. Alright, I'm going to use a single zero brush. So one size smaller, and that should be, yeah, that's plenty for the face. Okay. So what I'm going to do is attempt to make this lighter, and I'm going to do that by, how the heck am I going to do this? Alright, let's try this color. Shake it up. Do, 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 shake it up. Shake it up, baby. Alright, a little bit of beige. And I do mean a little bit. Drop. Alright, I don't think that's going to do much. But we'll find out. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to mix it into about the halfway mark of my my puddle of paint, and just see if it makes a noticeable change. Not really. I mean, there's a line right there. You might be able to see the difference between this color and that color over here, but not really that, not really much. So let's see here. I suppose throwing my brush. All right, let's start out by using this and just see what happens. Because it's gonna get lighter as we progress. So let's just see. All right. Okay. So I'm gonna focus. Let's first do the ears. Nice simplistic area. It would help if I was in frame, wouldn't it? Okay, so let me pull the model over and then do this. It's actually a pretty noticeable difference once it's on the miniature itself, so that's not bad. I can deal with that. Yeah, I think that's going to work. I think it's a good starting place. Because that's really all we need. We need to know where we want it to go. And then we need a starting place. And then we're basically done. Because all you got to do is jump from your starting place to your ending place. And it takes some steps to get through that journey. But that's the most simplistic process that you can take when painting a miniature. Just find your ending place, find your starting place, and do what it takes to get from one to the next. I know that's like deep philosophical stuff and everything. Yeah, right. But seriously, honestly, that's really all it is. There's nothing more to miniature painting other than where do you want it to go and where are you right now? And that's about it. And again, that's sort of the way it is with everything in life. Where am I right now? Where do I want to go? And what do I need to do to make it so that I am where I want to go? Okay. A little bit of color in this area. I will avoid that nice shadow right there. That's a beautiful shadow. Okay. And then we'll kind of blend it back in when it comes underneath like that. I might do something with the muzzle of the lion. Not really sure if I'm going to make it darker or not. I'm going to have to take a look at some pictures of some lions and see how the muzzle tends to look. I think, if memory serves me correctly, that like most animals, the nose and the muzzle area is slightly darker than the rest of the face. But before I do something stupid, I'm going to take a picture, or I'm going to take a look at a picture and just see. It's always good to have a little reference photo or something like that that you can consult, or if you're painting like I do, where it's multiple sessions of painting. And always just grab the internet and remember what you saw. And you don't have to have that photograph right there with you, so it makes it a little bit more helpful. And again, if you're just joining us for this episode of Watch Me Work, you may never have seen another one previously. This is not really meant to be a tutorial of any kind. These are specifically meant as a nice, relaxing, just watch a piece of art be created type video. And to be perfectly honest with you, if you want to get technical, that's what most of the quote-unquote tutorials are here on YouTube anyway. They're not really tutorials at all. They're really just, hey, look what I can do. But, you know what? That's fine. Some people might be able to learn from something like that. There we go. Let's go ahead and get the rest of that nose done up. I need to take a look and see about a lion's eye as well. See what sort of color it is, if it's a brown or a very, very almost black color. I'm sure it's probably going to be a brown, but I'm not 100% positive. All right, and the shadows on this model are just fantastic. They're just so well sculpted in. Makes the painting monumentally easier. Okay. There we go. Okay. I think we're going to call that good for our first highlight. So let's move on to highlight number two. I'm just going to continue with that same color. Add a little bit more. And mix it in and see what we end up with. Grab my mixing brush. Scoop my lion out of the way. always forget which way to move this thing when I'm looking at the camera. I don't have the television hooked up like I normally would to tell me which direction to move something to get it into frame when I'm doing these YouTube videos. I'm actually working off of the little LCD screen on the camera, and everything is inverted. So I have to go up when I want to go down, I have to go left when I want to go right. It's really, really annoying. But that's okay. Alright. More paint in the brush. And back to the model. Let's see what we can do. Let's see. By the way, if you happen to hear any sort of rumbling or anything like that in the background, that is my fan. It is a miserably hot day here in Alabama. And I've got two fans and an air conditioner running, a whole house air conditioner going. But one of the fans is very, very loud. So if you happen to hear anything, that's probably what it is. Go. I think we'll call that good. And now on to the actual face of the lion itself. Okay, let's start here with this little point on the brow, because we know that gets a highlight. And then I'm going to have to start breaking up the brow on the left and the right, because we've got some small shadows in here. There we go. That'll work nicely. And I know you guys can't see anything what I just did, because it wasn't on the side of the lion that you guys were looking at. There we go. I'll just kind of halfway go over it again, because it needs more paint anyway. So. I'm fighting a little bit of a sinus infection here lately, so I apologize for... Every now and again, you might see my hand go off camera and I'll get quiet, and that's me grabbing a tissue to wipe my nose. Just ignore it. Ignore the man behind the curtain. You don't see him. He's not here. Little bit more right there, and then we'll kind of hit this area of the muzzle. Do something like that. This is going to have to get much, much lighter in order to really make a dramatic difference. But that's okay. We'll do however many layers it takes. By the way, if you see me placing my hands or my fingers on the miniature itself to stabilize it, as a quick painting tip while I'm doing it and thinking about it, you might occasionally want to do what I call saving your work. If you're like myself and you position your fingers on something that you might have previously painted, during the painting process, after you finish a particular area, you might want to take it outside and give it a nice flat coat of Tester's Dull Coat. Just as a precautionary measure. Doesn't harm the paint job at all to have multiples on there, or multiple coats of Tester's Dull Coat. And it's just an easy, easy way to protect your model from your fingerprints, you know, the friction of your fingers being on the miniature. Whatever the case may be, the Tester's Dull Coat will help protect the paint job that you've finished on the miniature. And it doesn't have to be a complete paint job, it can just be, as I said, a single section or something like that. So, for those of you that wait until the very, very end to varnish your miniatures, you do not have to do that. If you paint them in sections, or if you can't paint an entire miniature at once, just varnish what you've done. And that way, that area, at least, will be somewhat protected. Let's get the lip here, the lower lip. And I think I'm going to ignore the jowl at this point. Going to ignore the jowl? What? No. The jowl of the lion. Alright, let's see here. I'm going to come in and get the nose. Some days I wish I could paint more swiftly than I do, but at the same time, I really enjoy going slow and just relaxing while I do this. I mean, I know we're already at the 15-minute mark, so what I'll probably do is probably cut the video after our next highlight and pick it up after that. But you can see, I hope at least, I mean, I can see it, a very, very clear delineation between what we've done here on the face and this arm, say, over here that's just been base coated. Very, very striking difference in the two. This is much whiter, much brighter, much more bold, and these are much more orange in appearance. So what I'm going to do now, I think, is add a little bit more of this color in, and just see how it goes. Let's see what happens. Ooh, yeah. Now that's a change I was looking for. That's a nice shift in color. Okay. A little bit more water in the brush here. There we go. You guys see that? I hope you can see that shift in color, because that is a huge, huge jump, which is good. I was getting to the point where I was thinking I was going to have to put 10 or 12 layers on this guy. But a shift like that, as long as I water it down so you can still see through it, should assist in decreasing the number of layers that I have to have. I'm just pulling some excess dried paint out of my the ferrule of my brush right now very quickly. If you happen to have, let me see if I can show you guys this. If you happen to have any dried paint, like right there at the very, very base of the bristles and the metal, I don't know if you can see that sort of beige-ish color right there. I tend to just take my fingernail and kind of press down and then lift up. And it sort of bends the bristles a little bit, but it breaks that dried up paint off. And you might lose a couple of bristles in the process. Sometimes the glue wears out when you do this, and that's fine. But what you don't want is that paint sticking in there for days and days and days, or weeks, or whatever the case may be. Because what that will do is it'll almost, when that paint dries, it'll almost act like a little tiny rock or a tiny grain of sand. And as you paint, it's going to cut into those bristles on the side, and the bristles are going to start falling out. So what you want to do is you want to get it off as soon as you can. Okay. All right. Now, we've got another load of paint right here, and we're just going to start working. There we go. Okay, and then a little bit maybe down in this area. Kind of lifting that up a little bit. Alright. I'm a little worried, to be honest with you, that the base coat that I laid down on this portion of the fur, or the skin, or whatever you call it, I'm going to call it fur, because technically it is fur-covered skin, is not quite dark enough. I almost feel as though we could have had a little bit darker base coat, and that would help bring some of these shadows out a little bit more fully. But we're going to do what we do right now. And hopefully I can finagle the paint enough. That's a technical term, by the way. Finagle. I can finagle the paint enough to where we'll end up with some really, really good shadows as well as some highlights. But we shall see. A little bit of paint here, I think. A lot. I want to keep that line in between those two. And you'll forgive me if I talk to myself while I'm doing this. I'm a very logic-oriented person. If you couldn't tell by the way that I paint, I do everything very systematically, very logically, and a lot of times I have to talk things out to try and figure out what specifically I'm going to be doing in a certain area. It just helps me to keep my mind on track of where certain things and certain colors need to go. Alright. Put that right there like so. Here across the lip, and then do this side over here as well. Got to be careful though. All right, that's pretty good. All right, now let's hit top of the brow here. Here. I'm starting to see some good highlights and good shadows combined here, so I don't think we're going to have any problems once I get the remainder of the highlights on this model with contrast. I think it's going to come out nicely, which is good. One of the things I was somewhat hesitant about. Getting that yet or not. We're going to get it again though, just in case. Alright. Hope you guys are enjoying this watch me work stuff. I know I enjoy it. You know, it gives me a chance to get out some more videos. A lot of people have been asking for painting videos for years, and I was trying to figure out how to do it, and this was the first thing that came to mind. You know, if people can do Let's Plays, where you just watch somebody play a video game, then, you know what, we can do a Watch Me Work on me painting a miniature, and I think it'll work quite nicely. So, anyway, let's see here. Alright, I think we're going to call that done for right now. Because we're at the, we're about 25 minutes in. So, I think we're going to call that a video. And we'll pick up next time, finish up the highlighting, try and finish up the face work here. But that's all I got for you guys today. So, I appreciate you watching. Thank you very much. Go ahead and if you have any comments or questions, feel free to leave them down in the comment section down below. Also, leave a thumbs up for this video as well. It always helps. And if you have not subscribed to AG Productions, go ahead and hit that subscribe button as well so you don't miss any of our really fun videos. Anyway, that's all I got for you guys, so thank you very much for watching. God bless you all. Have a fantastic rest of the day, and I will see you all in the next video.